Advantage Basketball Camp is in town again. Gil and Gabrielle, a couple, right?
Correct.
Okay. Making sure. I like the shirts, man. Looks very very authentic.
Thank you.
Yeah. So you guys, I know, move around the country with the basketball camps, and we've talked before, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Last year.
So you're back in Tahoe for this Monday through Thursday.
Exactly.
Talk a little bit about who it's for, where to go, what's going to happen.
Okay, good. So it's for boys and girls ages 6 to 18. All ability levels. This is actually one of our most anticipated stops. We love coming here as coaches, and as well, a lot of parents and kids repeat. This is our third year.
Uh-huh.
And
what do you like about Tahoe so much?
Well, I love the weather and the high altitude. Yeah. I love the lake, of course. I love being able to see snow in the hills and at the same time hike.
Is it good, though, to come up here to the altitude and do this? Because then I know you go back down to then these lower elevations. Do you feel the difference? Because you guys are from sea level, Marina del Rey.
Right.
Do you feel the difference?
Feel it a little bit.
A little bit. Not too bad. It's like right at that cusp. I mean, you're going to be over, I know, at Kale, like 6,400 feet or so. So it's kind of right on the cusp where you start to feel it. So who are we marketing to? I mean, who are you trying to get? You get a kid who say, hey, I never played basketball. Can I come learn?
Absolutely.
Yeah?
Like, that's the beauty of, I believe, with our coaching program. We work with any level of kid at whatever their level is. They could be second-year Division I player. They could be a six-year-old girl who's never played ball. The coaches have many ways to teach different things on all kinds of levels. Mm-hmm. We're very engaging. Parents can come out there, videotape, watch. Coaches should come out and learn, because I even have some coaches that are coming out and learn.
Learn how to coach.
Learn how to coach and some techniques. In fact, the coaching staff, which is a couple of my teammates and myself, have about 37 years of professional playing and coaching experience, and we're still actively involved.
Yeah. My dad did a bad thing to me. Growing up, I was a wrestler and a football player. You know, I'm not a very big guy, but, you know, in high school, that all works. But my dad early on said to me, he said, you're like me. You're not good in basketball. And man, what a difference that makes to a kid. I mean, my dad's great. I don't mean, you know. But he did, you know, he wasn't good at basketball. And he said that to me. And I never then ever, unfortunately, never put much energy into basketball.
Sure.
I mean, it seems like it's one of those sports. Certainly more than football and wrestling, it has longevity in your life. You know what I mean? At this point, I could still be, you know, going and playing some hoops with some guys. I'm not wrestling with my buddies like we used to, and I'm not playing, you know, full contact football, you know?
Right. Totally.
So how important is that? Like, when you're working with the kids, to be like, you're doing great, you're doing good, you're amazing. It's important,
It is extremely important. And look, we're not building LeBron James. That's not what we're doing. But we can improve every single player at their level.
If you could, then you could make a lot of money.
Yeah.
You should try and build one of those.
Maybe it's a good idea.
Maybe your focus is on the wrong thing. God, exactly. How about that guy, huh?
Fantastic.
Actually, Gil does, and his coaches do work with high school kids who are now going into college, and helps to guide them in that direction.
So are they playing some basketball too? Because I mean, I can remember as a kid, like going to football, like go to football, go wrestling camps. You're like, I just want to wrestle somebody. Yeah. I just want to get out there. But, you know, you end up in these drills and you end up doing this. And a lot of times as a kid, when you're young, I mean, I know this is like ages 6 to 18.
Yeah.
Sometimes when you're a kid, you're like, what are we doing this for? I don't get it. I mean, how do you get that across to a kid? I mean, they have to have desire to want to improve,
well,
right?
Here's how it goes. We have a series of drills that we do. Then we mix in informal scrimmaging that is supervised. Us as coaches have a lot of experience and knowledge and can do everything we're asking better than anyone we're asking them to do. So they'll understand when we explain why, how, when, where to use it. Then they do drills, get their feet wet, so to speak, pop them into scrimmages, supervise a little bit.
Yeah.
And that's it.
That's awesome, because that's what the kids want to do. I mean, it's the same thing like with ski racing up here, you know. You can get into all the technique and coaching. Yeah. But sometimes the kids just want to go skiing, man, or they want to just play.
Totally.
They have, hopefully the kids start out with a love for the sport of basketball, right? And then from there, you work with it. I mean,
well, it's interesting.
And then how do you look at it? Because, I mean,
at it differently, too.
Go ahead.
We have kids who may not have quite a love for basketball, but then after they have more of a love. And that's actually our goal, is to have parents, kids, whoever, have a greater appreciation and love for the game.
Mm-hmm.
We let the game teach itself. We have certain drills that have proven to be pretty effective.
Like, for example, give me...
Oh,
what's a real good one? You go, this drill works.
Well, one of them is a little more of an advanced drill as we get involved. It's called the UCLA drill, developed by John Wooden. It's called the John Wooden drill.
Mm-hmm.
He's a legendary coach. Anyway, that drill teaches a whole bunch of things in terms of when to come in on defense, when to pull out on offense, spacing on the court, timing for passes, ways of playing defense. Mm-hmm. That all those kind of things are in there. And then there's certain drills we do that are in stationary lines, which are based on ball handling. Everyone brings a basketball to camp. They bring their own.
Bring their own.
Because they're using it a lot. It's not like they're sitting on the side watching movies, doing other things. No, it's basketball.
So yeah, just hanging on to it, touching the ball, always having contact. Yeah.
Yeah.
I can remember doing that fumbling in a game a few times, and then the coach saying, "You got to carry the football around all week." You know, so you learn how to hold on to the damn thing. Don't put it down. Don't drop the football. And I don't know that it helped or anything. It kind of, but what it did is had everybody in school making fun of me carrying a football around for a whole week. You know.
So we don't tell people to carry basketballs around with them in school.
Exactly. Can kids still register for this program?
Yes, they can do it two ways at this point. They can go online to advantagebasketball.com and find the appropriate link, 2, 3, or 4 day, whatever they want to do. Or they can actually come the day of at the Kale Community Center in the morning and just come there, and we can take care of their paperwork on the spot.
Do you agree with me that the Harlem Globetrotters are the best basketball team in the world?
Yes, I know you asked me that last year. I'm going to give it to you.
Okay, I know.
A lot of great entertainment. I'll say that.
Why don't they just take them to the Olympics? I could totally see them like patting the guys on the head from China, you know, and putting it through the guys' legs in Africa. That'd be great.
They could probably do that. And then they could get a show in Vegas as well.
Well, you must have some contacts. Talk to your people. Have them call my people. The Advantage Basketball Camp starts on Monday, 9 to 4, through Thursday at the Kale Community College. And I think the website and everything up there on the screen. Thanks for coming back to town. Thanks for bringing
Thank you.
Anything that helps the kids to town is always good.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah, come
Appreciate
back
it.
Again next year. We'll talk to you again.
Okay.
Hey, we're done here on the show. I've got to go to a commercial, and then we'll come back and say goodbye. Stay with us.